Alta Mesa family, this is Mr. Avelina here to give you your first tip on being successful during our distance learning. Like normal learning, the most important part is to be organized. As a father and a teacher, I have three little ones at home. We have to be organized as at school, coming to home, to different environments. And it starts with the backpack. Backpack essentials start here. Every night before you go to bed, you need to make sure your Chromebook is put in your backpack. Don't forget your charger. That's incredibly important. It'd be nice if you charge your Chromebook every night. If you can't, at least put your charger in the backpack. You always want to keep your learning materials organized and inside your backpack. So all my books go in first, my hard books. Books with no papers that are going to fall out. We put those in the backpack as well. Don't forget your box with your learning tools, your pencils, your erasers, and everything else you may need. Lastly, you have all these loose papers. Hopefully your teacher gave you a folder. If not, any folder will do, or a bag or something where you can put your papers inside to keep them wrinkle free. You put that also in the backpack. We zip it up, and you wanna make sure you put that backpack in your learning space by your desk, or if you plan on going somewhere to daycare, to auntie's house, or to school or anywhere, you put it by your shoes or your table, a place you won't forget. And again, you want to do this the night before. And as a parent, this is incredibly helpful. Keep organized and your life will be so much easier. Thank you for listening.
Okay, families, number two on our tutorial list for you is the almighty mute button in Google Meets. So to mute yourself in Google Meets, you might have to wiggle your mouse a little bit and it pops up at the bottom. If the button's red, that means we cannot hear you. If it is not red, if it's gray, then we can hear you. And if it's ungrayed, then we can hear anything going on in your house. So make sure if you don't want us hearing you that it's red, and if your teacher asks you a question that you make it unread so we can hear what you're saying.
Hello, Alta Mesa parents and families. This is Mrs. Malik. I'm here to go over tip number three for Google Meets, and that is tabs. Are you ready? Here we go. First, I'm gonna start by showing you the Meet tab. So students are always in the Meet tab with us. You will see it says Meet up here and a little green camera and a red dot. So the students start in here. They can toggle, they can stay on the Meet with us and toggle into their classroom. So that's what I'm going to show you right here. This happens to be my third grade class, the Super Smarty class, and we're gonna toggle in. So if a student is in the Meet, I'm logged in as Sawyer. I'm gonna go into my Google Meet, and now I'm still in the Meet, and now I'm in the Super Smarty class classroom, and I wanna go to classwork. And then for example, today we did Chomp a Noun, so the students and I do this together. I share my screen with them and they are just going back and forth, and we open up the assignment and then they can open it up here and be able to do the assignment live with me together. So that is how to manage the tabs. They are able to go from the Meet to opening classwork, and when they open a classwork, that will just open up another tab, and you'll see that up here at the top. So then this is the tab that the actual classwork will be in. And that's it. Thank you for helping us.
Hello, I'm Mrs. Brewer with your fourth tip for being successful in distance learning. So on the Google Classroom, a lot of my students have found that an assignment won't pop up, or they can't find our Google Meet. So what I tell them is if they go to the top part over here, they can push refresh. And the refresh button, then a lot of the time their assignment pops up or the Google Meet pops up, and then they can click into their lesson. So if it's being slow, I would push refresh over and over again until it pops up for you. Okay, thank you.
All right, last thing for you is a few little tips for Google Meets. So in Google Meets, there is usually at the top of the screen on the right, left-hand side, there is a little emoji with their hand raised. That's a great button for your students to click if they have a question, and your teacher will get to you as soon as it's appropriate. Another little tip is to be able to unpin yourself or pin your teacher. So if you hover over your teacher's picture and you click the little thing that looks like a push pin, it will pin your teacher so you can just see them. If you are only seeing yourself, you might hover over your own picture and click the unpin so that you can see your teacher. And one last little thing is, you also have a feature up here on the left-hand screen, the left-hand part of the screen, that's your chat box. You can always type in a question there, and again, your teacher can get back to you as soon as possible.